السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Continuation of the series of أسماء الله الحسنى, we're still with Allah سبحانه وتعالى الرافع, the exalter. Allah سبحانه وتعالى الرافع, He is the one who raised Prophet Musa عليه السلام, and even Pharaoh's made sure that all the children, the male children, to be killed, and only he kept the females, because he was told that his destruction of his kingdom going to be one of these children from Bani Israel. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent that child, which is Prophet Musa, to his palace for him, for the Pharaoh to raise him, and he's the one against his will, without it is known, and and that's a challenge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Pharaoh. So Pharaoh did all what he could to prevent that from happening. فالتقطه آل فرعون ليكون لهم عدوا وحزنا إن فرعون وهامان وجنودهما كانوا خاطئين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala الرافع, he's the one who will raise whomever he wants, and he will bring down whoever wants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala الرافع, also the story said that the lady, she has a very small house nearby the palace of the king, and one time a king saw that small house and asked him to destroy this house and to add it to his properties. So when the woman came back to find her house was destroyed, and she raised her hands to and supplicated, "Oh Allah, I was away looking for my provisions, and where were you when this happened to my house?" So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ordered the angel Jibreel to destroy the palace of the king, and that was the response from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to this woman when she supplicated for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise his believers, especially who will stick to the Quran al-Kareem. إن الله يرفع بهذا الكتاب أقواما ويضع به آخرين يرفع درجتهم ويشرفهم ويكرمهم في الدنيا والآخرة. Whoever will stick to the Quran al-Kareem, recite, memorize, when you want this life, you stay closer to the Quran al-Kareem. When you want the afterlife, stay closer to the Quran al-Kareem. When you want both of them, you stay closer to the Quran al-Kareem too. So this is what you get when you get closer to the Quran al-Kareem all the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise the one who recites and memorizes the Quran al-Kareem, because يجيب القرآن يوم القيامة كالرجل الشاحب يقول لصاحبه هل تعرفني؟ أنا الذي كنت أسهر ليلك وأضمؤ هواجرك، وإن كل تاجر من وراء تجارته، وأنا لك اليوم من وراء كل تاجر، فيعطي الملك بيمينه والخلد بشماله، ويوضع على رأسي تاج الوقار، ويكسل والده الحلتين لا تقوم لهما الدنيا وما فيهما، فيقولان يا رب أن لنا هذا، فيقول بتعليم ولدكم القرآن. القرآن الكريم, when you teach your child the Quran and or you memorize yourself the Quran, this will come, the Quran will come in the day of judgment, and he will say, don't you know me? I am the Quran, is the one that who you spend the nights to recite, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the Quran Kareem to intercede, and he will give you the eternity and also you will be given a throne, in a special throne. And not only that, also your parents or the parents will be decorated with a throne also. And even they would not know what happened, where this come from, say, because you taught your child al-Quran al-Kareem. Allah subhanahu wa Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Mizan biyad al-Rahman yarfa aqwaman wa yada'u akharin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who raised, the one who will bring down anybody. When you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rafa, you will never go to anybody else. You always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not going to ask anybody. وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا فَاتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ. So when you stay closer to the Quran, when you stay closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sooner or later will raise you and will stand behind you. He may test you, but when you stay strong with his deen, but always you, at the end, it's going to be for in your favor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Rafa, that you should, from that name, you should be humble. You should not be arrogant. You should just know that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that to go to. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man tawada'a lillahi rafa'u. When you stay humble, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise your rank, will raise your position, will raise everything related to you. وَمَا تَوَاضَعَ أَحَدٌ لِلَّهِ إِلَّا رَفْعَهُ. Also, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, whoever will be humble, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise him for sure. Also, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَا مِنْ آدَمِيٍ إِلَّا فِي رَأْسِ حِكْمَةٌ بِيَدِ مَلِكٍ إِذَا تَوَاضَعَ قِيلَ لِلْمَلِكِ أَرْفَعَ حِكْمَتُهُ وَإِذَا تَكَبَّرَ خِذَ الْمَلِكِ دَعَ حِكْمَتُهُ. So if whoever will be humble, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the angel that who in charge of that to raise the person rank. And if anybody get arrogant, for sure sooner or later Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring him down. So رب أشعث أخبر ذي طمرين لا به له لو أخصم على الله لأكبره. Do not underestimate whoever someone humbled or someone simple, that he may very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to him. اللهم يا من رفع السماوات السبع وتجليت باسمك الرافع فرفعت أقدار أنبيائك ورسلك وأوليائك فارفع عندك درجاتنا وارفع شأننا وذكي نفوسنا ونور طريقنا وسلم من الآفات أجسادنا ومن الشرك قلوبنا واغفر ذنوبنا يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.